Pink Nightmare.
Do I need to repeat why I hate Pinkie Pie?
Oh, so many people babble on about how much they love Season 1 Pinkie Pie and her random humor, but I can't stand her, okay? Her voice and speech patterns are annoying. Her jokes are random, but lacking in actual humor. Her songs are all written by Tim Noah, and she has no real purpose of existing except to be the Phoebe of the group.
And they still give her a character development episode. Now, a character development episode, or CDE, is an episode, or a portion of an episode, dedicated to developing a specific character. And apparently today's episode is to develop it. Now, while you laugh and I weep, here's my review of Griffon the Brush Off. So, we open to Pinkie Pie talking about how great Rainbow Dash is. Okay. Is Shroom even a sound effect?
And then she looped around and around like woo, 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 woo.
Oh, Twilight, never stop tolerating your friends. You're hilarious when you try.
Pinkie Pie goes after Rainbow Dash, who, for some reason, is annoyed by Pinkie Pie. Like I said last episode, continuity is in one of the show's strengths.
I'm in the middle of something. I said not now. I was gonna tell you to look out for that mountain.
Then just say it. Instead of saying, "But Rainbow Dash," you should probably say, "Rainbow Dash, watch out for that treat." Never mind. You're not actually humming music. At least when Discord showers, he's singing Winter Wrap Up.
Twilight, have you seen Rainbow Dash anywhere?
Isn't she right up there?
Rainbow Dash!
Rainbow Dash is gonna get mutilated, isn't she?
Rainbow Dash runs away from the element of cartoon logic, as they do a tribute to old Pepe Le Pew cartoons. Sad they didn't spoof Roadrunner cartoons, though. Soon, Rainbow Dash gives in to Pinkie's chasing, when all Pinkie needed her for was to set up a prank.
Aw, no fair. I was promised My Little Pony mutilation is magic. Peter ruins everything.
No, no, a little to the left. Wait, back to the right. Stop. Maybe a few inches to the south. And now a couple centimeters north.
Great. Not only do they want me to laugh at Pinkie's jokes, they also want me to like her because she acts like Stanley Kubrick. You leave Stanley out of this. I like to see Pinkie Pie direct Barry Lyndon. Okay, so what's this prank?
Oh, Rainbow Dash, we startled Spike into getting the hiccups!
Oh my gosh, it is a lame joke.
We're much the same thing. We're true of scrolls.
Celestia does too.
I didn't take you for a prankster, Pinkie Pie.
I would, especially since Pinkie Pie sounds like the name of a poodle love interest for Pee Wee Herman's dog, Speck.
You know, Pinkie Pie, you're not as annoying as I thought.
Well, ain't you a jerk face?
So Rainbow and Pinkie begin a reign of terror on Ponyville with their pranking. Great job, guys. You gave her the contagion virus. Now she's going to join Kate Winslet in Nazi hell. It's fine. Twilight was just writing a feminist manifesto about the depiction of alicorns in the media. You better appreciate this prank, Applejack. They spend days painting every apple in this orchard.
Is someone over there? Who are we gonna squirt? Who are we gonna squirt?
This can't be taken out of context.
Fluttershy. What? No. We can't prank Fluttershy. I mean, she's so sensitive. It'll hurt her feelings. Even our most harmless prank.
Well, I'll admit, at least they gave Pinkie Pie standards. Already, this is a better CDE than Applebuck season. Because they actually decide to develop the character. So, the next day... Good lord, why can't they just send this character back to Adventure Time where she belongs?
It's a brand new day and we got a lot of pranking kids! Ooh. Morning, Pinks! Gilda, this is my gal pal, Pinkie Pie. Hey, what's up?
Huh. There's a new character brought into the mix. Well, let's see what she's like.
She's half eagle, half lion, and awesome. That's right.
Oh, please don't.
Gilda's my best friend from my days at Junior Speedster Flight Camp. Hey, remember the chant?
Sure. They made us recite it every morning. I'll never get that lame thing out of my head.
Oh, great. They made her into a 90s emo bad girl. They didn't even make Gilda into the fun type of could-care-less-about-the-world emo bad girl. You know, the Ramona Flowers, Lizzie Kaplan, Audrey Plaza type. Instead, they tried to fuse that kind of character with Cher Horowitz and... it just doesn't work.
Junior speedsters are our lives, skybound swords and daring dives.
I don't want no teenage queen, I just want my M14.
But Dash, you promised me we'd get a flying session in this morning.
Yeah, well, Pinkie Pie, you don't mind, do you?
I don't mind. Even if Gilda's an unoriginal character, she's still better than Pinkie Pie. So, Pinkie does what she's best at. Stalking the living heck out of her friends.
Oh, hey there!
Huh?
It's later! And I caught up!
Huh. So, this episode is about a pink psychopath obsessing over a blue ditz who becomes unhealthily jealous when the blue ditz's best friend is brought into the mix. I wonder where I've heard... This is just my favorite episode of Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends! Yeah, remember the episode where Blue had a sociopathic admirer who tried to kill Mac on multiple occasions? Yeah, they made a My Little Pony episode out of that. And yes, Very Scary is my favorite episode. Barry is just a hilarious villain. The humor and satire works well. And it has that warm, cozy feeling that's present in most episodes of Foster's. If Mopfim were to try and saturate that for little girls, the results would be disastrous.
Altitude is making you dizzy.
Well, I don't remember Mac doing that. I keep expecting Gilda to more or less strap Pinkie Pie to a giant rubber band ball, but I didn't really expect...
Don't you know how to take get lost for an answer?
Oh, Puddles. So, it turns out Gilda hates Pinkie's presence because, wait, why?
Dash doesn't need to hang with a dweeb like you now that I'm around.
Oh, so it's Valley Girl in reverse. Pinkie Pie is so upset with this unorthodox behavior, she goes to complain to Twilight.
So, Pinkie Pie, are you sure that this friend of Rainbow Dash is really so mean?
Well, she caused Pinkie Pie to crash her flying contraption, so I'd say that's pretty mean.
You know what I think, Pinkie Pie?
Well, I think you're jealous.
Jealous?
Green with envy. Well, in your case, pink with envy.
Yes, because we're not delving into green with envy until episode 20. You know, Twilight does have a valid, if not flawed, argument. For one thing, Pinkie Pie was jealous when Gilda first appeared, so it was rude of her to keep bugging Rainbow and Gilda, even if Gilda was equally rude. Though Pinkie doesn't seem like the sort of pony who would lie about Gilda and say she acted violently against her intrusions and crashed her contraption, it's not entirely out of the question. I mean, you never know what to expect from Pinky anyway. I kind of see where Twilight is coming from, though I don't see how Twilight can really trust someone she's never met over one of her best friends. Pinky reluctantly thinks about what Twilight said.
Maybe Twilight is right. Maybe Gilda isn't a big, mean, grumpy, mean, meanie pants. Maybe I'm just a big, jealous, judgmental, jealous, jealousy pants.
Not to mention jealous. Hey, then we see the true maliciousness of Gilda.
A rattler! A rattler! Run for the hills! Everybody run, save yourselves!
Aw, poor Granny Smith! She didn't know it was a joke! How mean! No, no, I can't misjudge her. It was kind of a funny prank.
Fluttershy, too sensitive. Old ladies with heart conditions? Let me go put on my Michael Myers mask.
I did misjudge her! She's not only a meanie meat pants, she's also a thief!
Report Gilda to the police. Maybe we can have her imprisoned for 20 years for stealing an apple and torture her to death with Russell Crowe's diaphragm.
No. She might get it back.
Okay, but you have to wait a while. Good night, everybody!
All right, little ones. This way, this way.
Oh, no. Please, no.
Hey!
Please excuse me.
I'm walking here!
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just trying to...
I'm sorry!
Why don't you just watch where you're going, doofus?
But I...
You better fuck her up, you hear me, Pinkie Pie? So, Pinky decides that Gilda must be stopped once and for all.
Pinkie Pie style.
Now, does Pinkie Pie mutilate and or psychologically torture someone? Nope, she throws a party. Still hoping for mutilation.
Who's this Gilda I've heard nothing about?
Well, her full name is Gilda Munson Farrell. She's currently married to a man named Ballin, and she has a fan club located in Shawshank Prison.
Amongst all us pony folk.
Sad. I was expecting this to happen.
Oh, there'll be a hot time in the old town tonight.
I know what you're up to.
Great!
I know what you're planning.
Well, I hope so. This wasn't supposed to be a surprise party.
I mean, I've got my eye on you.
And I got my eye on you!
Don't doubt her, Gilda. She probably does.
Vanilla lemon drops. Don't mind if I do.
Hi! Gee, the punch!
Huh? Okay, these pranks are more like it. So, the party continues with prank after prank.
Hey, I'm watching you like a hawk.
Why? Can't you watch me like a griffin?
Okay, the third act has gotten surprisingly funny over the past few minutes. It's shocking, really. Eventually, Gilda gets sick of these endless misunderstandings and pranks, and lashes out on all the ponies with her outdated mumbo-jumbo.
I've never met a lamer bunch of dweebs in all my life!
And Pinkie Pie,
you are Queen Lame-o with your weak little party pranks!
I don't know about weak. I mean, one of the pranks did make you breathe fire.
Come on, Dash. We're bailing on this pathetic scene. Come on, Rainbow Dash! I said we're leaving!
You know, Gilda, I was the one who set up all those weak pranks at this party. What?
What an interesting plot twist.
Actually, this was an interesting plot twist. I really wasn't expecting that to happen. Continue.
So I guess I'm Queen Lame-o. Come on, Dash, you're joshing me.
If they were actually joshing you, I think Rainbow Dash would have said, "It's Spherical!"
They weren't all meant for you specifically. It was just dumb luck that you set them all off. I should have known! That dribble cup had Rainbow Dash written all over it.
Oh my god, this was actually foreshadowed when Dash said to drink the punch. This plot twist actually makes sense.
You know, this is not how I thought my old friends would treat my new friends. If being cool is all you care about, maybe you should go find some new cool friends someplace else.
Damn!
Yeah? Well, you are such a flip-flop. Cool one minute and lame the next.
Subtlety. This show's subtle about Gilda missing Rainbow Dash. That painful look. The stutter. They're not too subtle about Gilda being a poser, but just subtle enough. This show has finally found subtlety. So, Gilda leaves town, Rainbow and Pinky make up, and Twilight apologizes for misjudging Pinky. The lesson is...
Dearest Princess Celestia, today I learned that it's hard to accept when some pony you like wants to spend time with some pony who's not so nice.
Wouldn't it be some griffin?
Though it's impossible to control who your friends hang out with, it is possible to control your own behavior. Just continue to be a good friend. In the end, the difference between a false friend and one who is true will surely come to light. Your faithful student, Twilight Sparkle.
Pretty solid message. Don't try to gain attention, just continue to be your best. Pretty good message to end a pretty good episode. This episode has flaws. Gilda could have been a stronger character. Pinkie Pie acts like Season 1 Pinkie Pie most of the time, and logical conclusions are missing in some scenes. But that can be subsided for great animation, great character development, and a great moral. There are many times I laughed at this episode's jokes, and seeing as how Pinkie Pie was the main character, I have to say that's a big accomplishment of mine. The plot twist, the subtlety at the end, the animation tributes, the nostalgic throwbacks to Very Scary, the more low-key but still amusing jokes, so much to love about this episode. The only somewhat fatal flaw was Gilda. Good gracious, was she annoying. Why hasn't the bad girl stereotype evolved since 1997? I think it'd be nice to have an after-school special bad girl that didn't spout out lines written by 90s kid. Her design looks cool, though. I'll give her that. On a scale of 1 to 10, I give Griff on the Brush Off a 7 out of 10. Though I do wonder why I had night terrors about Pinky. I mean, it couldn't just have been me wanting some artistic merit, right? Right? If they were actually joshing you, I think the world would have exploded with the sound of a COPY!